Gran Turismo movie review. Let's start. Starting at the back of the pack, Neil Blomkamp has struggled a bit for a few seasons after his massive debut of District 9, a few bad laps with Chappie and Elysium, unable to finish the race with those two films. His writing crew this race, he's got Jason Hall, who wrote American Sniper and Paranoia, and Alex Shea, who wrote Wu-Tang American Saga and Watchmen. Alright, into turn one, we've got a nice spread of the underdog story of Jan Martinborough, a young UK gamer who plays a driving sim called Gran Turismo, portrayed by the lovely and sweet Archie Madekwe, but I can assure you there will be a lot of overtakes into this race by David Arbour. Up the inside we go. The determination of Jan Martinborough wanting to be a real race car driver is going to hold this one around the outside quite nicely. A bit of contact there by poor riding, but he's got the line. He's got the inside, and he's going to keep his position. Through the outer loop, we pick up a lukewarm romance story. Unfortunately, it doesn't seem this will give us any slipstream we can use to our advantage. Such a shame. Now, you might notice a Legolas in the back here, but I don't think he'll be able to do too much. Flying up the inside, getting the job done, David Arbour is Jack Salter, doing a wonderful lap as Jan's coach. Tight inside, emotional turns, what we've come to expect. Such a consistent driver. Alright, we're coming into the halfway through the race, and things aren't looking too great. Now, this is a bit of the race where you just have to churn out a bit of consistent racing tropes. It can be quite tricky. Trying to pull away from the paint-by-numbers racing template, we need to keep a safe buffer from a total feel-good story, so we'll add in a real-life tragedy of Jan Martinborough's experience. It's going to be really difficult to get this one right. We have a bit of oversteer moment on the curb by David Arbour, just trying to be nice and light on the true-life accident which killed a bystander. Through the final corner, we pick up a lot of cliche building towards a lot of underdog story advancements. Alright, we've got a lot of everyone being mean to the gamer, make fun of the sim driver bully moments. Can we use that slipstream to our advantage while we wait for a good moment for the underdog win overtake? You have to be so careful. That really is the main skill in this race. Deciding the balance to drive to. Do you push too much? Really go for it, but risk getting the penalty of being too cliche? And here I think Gran Turismo is pushing just a little too hard, and you'll see it just creates too large a gap for the story to recover from, despite those tight feel-good turns. A really good attempt overall. Not enough for a win, but clean race finishing with a solid C. Okay. Hey guys, it's Alachia. Just had to have fun with that one. Gran Turismo is an okay film. I didn't love it, but then again, I'm not a big Gran Turismo fan. My husband is, Azixa, and his love of this game introduced me, well, he would always have it playing in the background on his PlayStation 3, and I would always admire the graphics. I was like, it looked like real cars. It's absolutely stunning how much detail they go into in this game, which has sold over 90 million copies worldwide, and the appreciation for all cars, and just the ability to take those cars and sim drive cars you would never in your freaking life be able to even dream of driving. And the accuracy, the modeling, just the effects of the cars going through all the different environments. When the PlayStation 4 came out, I remember I was with my brother and we saw it was actually at Best Buy. And this was at the time where they were kind of sold out because it was one of those Black Friday type things. And we saw one and I was like, oh man, I don't want to get another dust collector because like PlayStations, that's what they are for me. Like, yeah, we're mostly PC gamers, but there's a couple of games that he plays on the PlayStation, Persona 5 being a huge one, and Gran Turismo, the other one. And I was like, well, man, with the PlayStation 4, I know we've come even more further since that, PlayStation 4, I was like, man, that's going to look amazing. That's going to look amazing. And I was like, fuck it. So I bought it. I was like, I want to at least be able to see what Gran Turismo looks like on the PlayStation 4. Now, clearly, the graphics have even upped themselves since then. But I remember I was like, I bought that and I was like, that's probably the last one I'll ever buy. But but I remember just thinking, I bought that just for Gran Turismo. I did, you know, because I was like, I don't even play the game, but I love watching it so much that I'm like, I want to see this. I want to see what it looks like, because I'm telling you, these guys push the limitations of simulated driving. And I don't even like racing. I'm not a big fan of cars, but this game is so well crafted. It's not a game, actually. It's a simulation. It's so well crafted that, you know, it's like art and you appreciate it. And I was really hoping that would translate into this movie, and it did not. Yes, it is, you know, the story involves Gran Turismo as a console simulator. However, this is really more about Jan Moderborough and his drive to succeed. This is, and it barely touches on the aspects of the simulator having an effect on his ability to be a better driver. I think that ultimately what it does show is that you can take a love of driving, have a simulator game inspire you, but then you have to take all of the extra steps to really become a good driver. Like the whole idea of, like, you know, the simulator is so good that, you know, you don't need real world experience in driving because that's how good it is. They make that clear that that's not the case. Yes, it will make you very familiar with a lot of the cars and how the races and the how all of the races are laid out, how to drive them, how to make, you know, turns, how to stay in your line. That all translates from the simulator. However, there's a giant component of racing that, you know, is all about learning and experience and really understanding how to handle the vehicle, which is why there was a moment when they actually got to the Le Mans track, and then they show this car come down, you know, and they're like, they look at the car and they're just like, wow, that's we're gonna get to drive that car, because it was a different car than the Nissan cars that they've been driving, because it was a Le Mans specific race car that they needed. And I was just thinking, no way, man, like, is that true? Is that the first time they drive that car will be on that track? Surely they must practice, right? I don't know. Maybe I don't know anything about race car driving or any of these races. I watched Ford versus Ferrari, excellent movie. This is a generic underdog story. Jan is so lovable. I know this is probably why they picked his story, because he as a character is just so sweet and you want to root for him because he's just overall a nice guy in real life. And the actual first person to go through the Gran Turismo Academy was Lucas Ordonez, a Spanish driver. And they decided to not go with him. I don't know why. Maybe as a character, he's not as lovable or as interesting. Or maybe it was just because, you know, they didn't want to go the Spanish route. Maybe they wanted to go with someone whose native language was English. I'm not sure. He just is a person in real life, Jan, who really is the embodiment of someone who has the drive to do something, has the patience, the willpower, and the perseverance, and the discipline to make that thing happen. And I think that's the overall beauty of this story of Gran Turismo, is trying to showcase that. However, there are moments where they do try to interweave the fact that, you know, having had some experience would make, you know, give him an edge to driving, which I don't think it does. And they did try to show that, you know, hey man, if you can have a chance to practice a couple hundred hours on the simulator, it gives you more options. But I also feel like probably a lot of real world hours gives you a lot of advantages as well. And then they tried to overplay the underdog story a little too much. It was definitely, everybody was like, oh, you're a stupid little gamer and your little sim. How dare you try to be a real race car driver? Even like his pit crew was like shitting on him. I was like, everyone was shitting on him. I was like, oh my God, I get it. All right. Yeah. Everyone doesn't believe in him. He can't do it. He's, you know, there's no way he can do it. He has to believe in himself. I was like, I get it. And then if you have never really watched a lot of underdog stories, this might feel really fresh. It might feel really, because that trope really works. It works well. The more you put someone down, the more you tell someone, hey, you can't do this. You can't do this. The more, as an audience member, you're like, fucking do it. Do it. And I think that it might be really successful for people who are kind of new to the underdog genre. And then in terms of the race car driving, I had a real problem with the editors being Austin Daines and Colby Parker. I wanted to see when they're racing. And one of the things I love about Gran Turismo is being able to watch, you know, the cars race, and it's very fluid and I can understand what's going on and I can see, you know, how the cars are behaving with one another. And it's, I just really appreciate watching that. In this case, we'd be going up, taking a turn. Clearly there's a pass going on, and just as you're like trying to figure out who's ahead of who, who's on edge with the other, how is their car behaving, it would just edit cut to a VFX of like gears, you know, going or pistons firing. And I was like, oh, wait, stop. I want to go back and watch the race, right? And I know they do that for effect. It's keeps things very dynamic. But as someone who just like, who doesn't like, you know, all the super fast cuts in martial arts fights, who likes to see the whole thing play out with not a lot of jumps. I'm the same way when it comes to watching anything with car chasing, car racing. I want to watch the overall view. I don't want to be zoomed into the wheel. Like, you know, it's like suddenly you have this amazing play or the car's behaving in a certain way and then boom, cut to the wheel. I'm like, I don't want to see the wheel. Unless the wheel has something to do with like a specific thing, I don't want to see the wheel. And they would just do that. They would constantly cut in, zoom in to like a part of the car. And I was like, this has nothing to do with what I was just watching. Please go back. Please zoom out. But I think if you like Gran Turismo and you like racing and you love a good underdog story, I think you're going to enjoy this film. It was just okay for me. It was funny though, when I asked my friend, I was like, do you want to go see this guy? I knew my husband was going to want to see this because obviously, asking my friend, I was like, do you want to go see this film? And he was just like, yeah, I do. I play Gran Turismo. But you know, the story, I mean, come on, it's not realistic, right? He's like, there's no way, like, you know, a gamer is going to be able to just make it as like a race car driver. And I was like, actually, it's based off a true story. But yeah, that is the premise that they market and advertise. But in reality, if you really think about it, you know, yes, they take people who have a love of driving, who play this sim to near obsession because they love driving so much. They love the idea of racing. And it's like a starter pack, right? But the real journey is, you know, being able to have access to the academy, winning a position in the academy, going through the academy, succeeding through the academy, and then having to prove yourself as a real driver. And, you know, they've since discontinued this Gran Turismo Academy because, you know, ultimately it was a marketing thing. You know, I think that's what this film kind of is as well. You know, it's just to get the name brand recognition out. It's a great Hollywood story. So anyways, let me know what you guys thought about Gran Turismo. If you plan to watch it, if you did, what do you think about it? Did you play the game? Do you like the game? How does it look on the PS5? I imagine it must look really amazing. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. And if you'd like to watch more, you can click right here or right here to watch more now. Until next time, see you on the flip side. Boom, 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 boom